السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله يا رب العالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. ما بعد، إن أفضل الحديث كتاب الله، خير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، كل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Hope that you can hear. تمام. The voice is okay. Voice is okay. تمام. طيب. Let's start our lesson. كتاب التوحيد. Chapter 44. Clear. تمام. What is the name of the author of the book? The book that we are using now. What is the name of the author, sisters? Without reading. Anyone knows the name of the author? Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab. This is not the author of the book. Our book is the concise commentary. Yes, Salih Fawzan. Yes, Sheikh Salih Fawzan, Dr. Salih Fawzan. Okay, Kitab Tawheed is Muhammad Abdul Wahhab is the author of who wrote Kitab Tawheed. But our book is the Al-Mulakhas by Sheikh Salih Fawzan. Okay? Tamam. Alhamdulillah, we got the answer. Yes. Dr. Salih Fawzan. And there is another sharh for Sheikh Salih Fawzan, Kitab Tawheed. This is one volume. He has another sharh, two volumes. And that book, wallahi, very nice. I like that book, mashallah. But I do not see the translation. I do not see the translation of the other one. I don't know if this translates, but for me, I did not see the translation. طيب. Chapter 44, page 347. باب من سب الدهر فقد آذى الله. باب من سب الدهر فقد آذى الله. Inveighing against the vicissitudes of time wrongs Allah. طيب من سب الدهر. To insult the time. Okay. You insult a day. You insult a month. You curse it. This is, he said, آد الله. You are bothering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's see what we have in this chapter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, he mentioned the ayah, وَقَالُوا مَا هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرُ. And they say there is not but our worldly life. We die and death, and nothing destroys us except time. And they have that no knowledge, they are only assuming. طيب. طيب وقال ما هي إلا حياتنا الدنيا. This saying from the kuffar. Page 347. This ayah from the kuffar, about the kuffar. They are called الدهريون. الدهريون. They believe in dahr. Dahr is the time. They believe that this is from the time. Okay. This is because of the time. Because my marriage was on Wednesday, so that's why it was spoiled. The marriage was in the month of Shawwal. Okay. It was successful. Okay, because of the time, we succeed or we fail. This is haram. This is haram. Okay, if you following the Sharia, okay, you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is needed. This is our job. I follow the Sharia. In the Sharia, nothing to, for example, regarding marriage, nothing about to marry on Wednesday or Thursday. because there is a belief that no, you should avoid marrying, doing the nikah on Wednesday. This is haram. Okay, this is haram. Why? Because we don't have proof to avoid Wednesday and marriage. Yes, we have about fasting. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned about fasting Friday alone. Yes, we have a hadith. Don't fast Friday alone. When he saw his wife fasting Friday, he asked her, have you fasted Thursday? No. Are you going to fast tomorrow, Saturday? She said, no. Then the Prophet said, don't fast Friday. Okay, yes, there are details about that, but generally. طيب. So the Dahriyun, what they say, Dahriyun from the word Dahr, the time. They say, this hayat, this life, ما هي إلا أرحام تدفع وأرض تبلع. This life, it is wombs pushing the baby outside, which means pushing the baby outside. وأرض تبلع, the earth absorbing us. It means the janazah. We bury the person. This is life. Birth and death, birth and death. So they don't believe in the hereafter. And this is haram. And they believe this life has a control, has an effect on the person, the days, the months, okay? And this is haram, no doubt, and this is like insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. And if we notice what they say, وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهْرِ. And they say there is not but our worldly life. We die and live. This is haram. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who gives life, and he causes a person to die. From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلِ اللَّهُ مَالِكَ الْمُلْكُ تُؤْتِي الْمُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ تُنْزِعُ مُلْكَ مَنْ تَشَاءُ تُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ وَتُذِلُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرُ. It is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah raises people up. Allah puts people down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the victory for people. It makes people to lose. Allah gives the kingdom for some people. Allah takes it from other people. Allah makes people to live, to die. It is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب. He mentioned a hadith عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عن hadith in page 349 that Allah, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that Allah says قال الله تعالى يؤذيني ابن آدم يسب الدهر وأنا الدهر قلب الليل والنهار. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says the son of Adam wrongs me يسب الدهر insults me for he inveighs against the vicissitudes of time, though I am the one who manages time and I cause the alternation of day and night. In another narration, it is related that the Prophet ﷺ said, don't inveigh against the vicissitudes of time, for Allah is the one who manages time. Bukhari and Muslim. First of all, this hadith is called Hadith Qudsi. Hadith Qudsi, holy hadith. How we know the Hadith Qudsi? When you see the beginning of the hadith, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says that Allah said, قال الله. Okay, and you'll find the scholars mentioning the difference between the Hadith Qudsi and the Quran. So Allah says in this hadith, يؤذيني ابن آدم. يؤذيني ابن آدم, the son of Adam wrongs me. طيب, here we should be precise. There is أذى and there is ضرر. أذى, for example, if I'm sitting like this and there is a fly, okay, during the class, for example, I have 1 hour class, طيب, and there is a fly. The fly comes here on my, this is called غترة. So I try to remove this. Then it comes on my nose. I do like this. It comes in on my hand. So what you say, this fly, it is يؤذيني or يضرني. Those who know Arabic. This is أذى or ضرر, sisters. What do you think? Ada, okay. This is Ada. What is the translation of Ada? Annoying, yes. Something annoying me, bothering me. This is adha. Because if there is a flight is coming here, there, not say harm. I think annoying, yani. Maybe more precise, annoying. It is annoying me, bothering me. Okay? Because this fly will not cause me yani injury here or bleeding or causing the person to be blind. But this is bothering the person. I will continue the class. Okay, irritating me. Something like this, yes. Because I will continue the class. Do you think that if there is a fly, okay, I'll tell you, sisters, please, there is a fly making trouble for me. I will not continue the class. We will not say that. Would not say that. Or for example, yani, if the temperature is yani hot, maybe the AC is not working very nice. So I will continue the class. Yes, it is bothering me, the hot weather, but I will continue the class. This is called adha. Dharar, what is the dharar? Dharar, no, there is, it is not a fly, it is a mosquito. Maybe 2-3 mosquitoes, and one of them came here. Then it is sucking my blood. The other one came the other side. It causes pain here, and or bees. So they are stinging me here and there, okay, causing some trauma here, there. Right? So this is darar. This is darar. Why? Because I need medicine, and I will not continue the class. I will leave the masjid. Or I will call someone to help us to kill these mosquitoes who are bothering or harming the people. Okay, so this is the difference between adha and darar. Okay, so maybe adha as translation, bothering, annoying, disturbing. Darar, it is harming, to cause a harm. You got it? Tamam? I hope this is clear. This is because here the translation wrongs Allah. I don't think that this is a correct translation. Why I'm saying that? Because if you know the difference between these two words, you will understand the Quran and Sunnah. Allah says in the here in this hadith, what you'll find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala proved, affirmed that there can be adha, that people can make adha for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sah? Okay? Adha can be done. Tayyib. Can we say people can cause harm? No, never. Can cause darar? Never. Why? Because the other hadith, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, hadith Qudsi, إِنَّكُمْ لَن تَبْلُغُوا ضُرِّي فَتَضُرُّونِي. You cannot reach to a level to harm me. So people can make adha for Allah, but they cannot make dharar, never. You got the point, sisters? I hope this is a clear point. This is important. Clear, sisters, or confusion? Clear? Kazma, she said clear. I need 2-3 people to say clear. Or should I repeat? Okay, so now you got the difference between adha and darar. So adha can happen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, yes. When people speak these words about the time. Can darar happen to Allah? Never. No one can cause darar. No one can harm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when you read in the Quran, Allah says about the kuffar toward the Muslim, لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ إِلَّا أَذَى. Okay, you know, this is like glad tidings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the believers. لَا يَضُرُّكُمْ إِلَّا أَذَى. You know, when the hypocrites speak and they try to spread the rumors. Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said they cannot harm you except bothering you, annoying you. For that situation. So here we come back to the hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the son of Adam wrongs me. Or let's say, bothering me, annoying me. Okay. how for he inveighs against the vicissitudes of time, though I am the time, and I cause the alternation of the of day and night. يؤذيني ابن أن يسب الدهر. Okay, I'm causing, for example, today is off, Saturday is off, okay, and we plan from the morning. I told my wife and my children, let's prepare for a picnic. The weather is nice in Kuwait, alhamdulillah. Nowadays it is relatively nice, yani the temperature, it is 33, very nice, mashallah. In the noon time, 33, 34, 32, mashallah, this is very nice. At night, it is 27, mashallah, very nice. So we decided to, we plan to make, to go on a picnic. Okay, so prepare the things. So from the morning, okay, when I want to start the car, it is not working. Okay, then I went here to the garage to fix the car. So I wasted maybe 2 hours. The plan is to leave home at 10. So now we are leaving the home at 12. So when we drove the car, we started, okay, there was a car accident. So this made us late for another 1 hour. But when we reached to the place, it was full, no space for us. So what a bad day. Okay, this is not our day. This is astaghfirullah. This is qadarullah. It is haram, you insult the day. This is qadarullah, the decree from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you don't know, maybe this is good for you. Being late or not to find a place in that garden or farm, maybe this is good for you. So it is haram to insult. Why? He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah said, وَأَنَا الدَّهْرُ. Okay, I am the time. I am time. Here, what is the meaning? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that Allah said, I am الدَّهْرُ. Does this mean الدَّهْرُ is one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? No. It is not one of the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because if you continue the hadith, what you will find? أُقَلِّبُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارُ. Okay? I am the time, which means the one who manages time. And I cause the alternation of the day and night. Okay, so this is the meaning of the hadith. There are scholars who said that Dahr is one of the names of Allah. Yes. Or what is known that Ibn Hazm, rahimahullah, said this is one of the names of Allah. But other scholars do not agree with him. They said, why? Because the Prophet ﷺ in the hadith explained what is the meaning of that statement. I am the time, which means I cause the alternation. The other narration, he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لا تسبوا الدهر. فإن الله هو الدهر. Don't inveigh against the vicissitudes of time, for Allah is the time, which means the one who manages time. So what is the point here, brothers and sisters? Now, maybe we are wondering, what is the relationship between this chapter or this hadith and Kitab Tawheed? What is the Tawheed of this point? The Tawheed of this point now, when we insult the time, I insult Monday, or I insult the month Shawwal, or I insult this year, or this date, anything from the time, what is the point? As if you believe that the time has an impact, the time can change the things. And this is haram, this is a kind of shirk. You should believe that Allah, and everything in the control of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you should not insult the time. Why? Because the time is one of the creation of Allah. Allah created the time, Allah created the place, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu khaliq kulli shay, Allah created everything. So what is the point when you insult or when you curse the time, the sun, the moon? As if you are cursing the creator of these things. So you should control your tongue and you follow the sharia. You say alhamdulillah, you say qadar Allah ma sha fa'al. Okay, if there is something wrong, and you should not insult the time or also the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. طيب, we go to the next chapter, 45, page 351. التسمي بقاضي القضاء ونحوه names such as the judge of judges and the like. في صحيح أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال إن أخنعس من عند الله رجل تسمى مالك الأملاك لا مالك إلا الله. قال سفيان مثل شاهن شاه. وفي رواية أغيض على الله يوم القيامة وأخبثه. قوله أخنع يعني أوضع من الحديث. أبو هريرة رضي الله عنه narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said the most awful meanest name in Allah's sight is that of a man called King of Kings. ملك الأملاك kings, King of Kings. For there is no sovereign but Allah. لا مالك إلا الله. Who's the real owner of everything? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He owns everything. The real owner subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sufyan is one of the narrators. He's tabi'in. He's not a companion one after the tabi'in generation. He said, such as the name of Shahan Shah. And another narration, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the most abominable and evil man in Allah's sight on the day of resurrection. طيب. Here, what is the point here? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, this is the worst. King of the kings. Where is the tawheed here? The tawheed that, if you remember, with the beginning of the book, we explain what are the types of tawheed. What are the types of tawheed? Tawheed al-rububiyyah, tawheed al-uluhiyyah, tawheed al-asma al-sifat. What does mean tawheed al-rububiyyah? That to believe that Allah is the only Lord, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he created everything. And to believe that Allah has actions. No one can do these actions. To give rain, to give life, to cause death, and to change the weather. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is rububiyyah, lordship of Allah. Uluhiyyah, our actions should be toward Allah alone, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-asma wa sifat, okay? Asma wa sifat, names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As we mentioned previously, to believe that Allah has names and attributes. No one has the same. And we should believe in these things without changing, without imitating or يعني resembling Allah with his creation. This is very important. So when you come here and you say, Wallahi, this man is the king of the kings. This is haram because the king of the kings, Allah, Malik al-Muluk, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And here the author said in the title, Qadi al-Qudar. The hadith, okay, the hadith talks about king of the kings. But the title, judge of judges. Why? Because the same concept. The same concept. You should not say Malik al-Muluk. You can say this person is the king of this country. The king of Kuwait, the king of Saudi Arabia, the king of UK, the king. Haram? Not haram. Okay. The Qadi of Kuwait, the Qadi of UK, the Qadi of Egypt. Qadi means the judge. Haram? Not haram. But when it becomes haram, when you say this is the king of the king. The king of the kings. Haram. Why? Because Allah is the king. And also this is the king of this country. Is Allah. But king of the kings, their leader, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or Qadi al-Qudah. Also this haram. But can I say king of the kings of a certain area? Okay. You keep it limited. This is allowed. But when you keep it general, haram. It is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do I mean? For example, in UK, let's say you have many cities, okay, or United States, you have many states, and every state there is a king. So I say this person is the king of the kings of the states. This is allowed. Why? Because you kept it limited for this area. Or he is the judge of the judges in Kuwait. Okay, this is allowed. Why? Because you made it clear as specific for Kuwait. So when we should avoid? When you keep it general. The Qadi al-Qudha, the judge of the judges. This is haram. The king of the kings. This is haram. Because who is the king of the kings? Allah. Subhanahu. Only Allah. سبحانه وتعالى. So we should not raise people to that level. We should keep them up to their level. You are a king of the country, okay. You are the judge of the country, it's okay. But king of the kings, judge of the judges, you should avoid that. And like Shahan Shah, okay, they use this word, they mentioned this word in Persian. It means also king of the kings. Shahan Shah, it is a Persian title. So now the issue is not only the exact word, the meaning. If you are using in your language, in English, in Persian, in France, in Dutch, whatever the language, okay? Also it is haram, should be only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. So again, what is the relationship between this chapter and Kitab al-Tawheed? Because this is one of the Tawheed that you should respect the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only for Him. You should not use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for people. If you remember, we mentioned this, وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ وَلِلَّهِ, Allah says, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءِ الْحُسْنَ فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. ولله الأسماء الحسنى فادعوه بها. For Allah the highest names, invoke Him by these names. وذروا الذين يلحدون في أسماء, and leave those who are making الحاد, those who have deviation in the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is one of the deviation regarding the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you use the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for others, this is haram. This is a unique name or special name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Why? Because there are names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can be used also by people. Okay, when we go to the next chapter, chapter 46, reverence of Allah's beautiful names. Ihtiram asma Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wa taghyir ism li ajli dhalik. Respecting the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, changing the names of Allah subhanahu, changing the names of the person to respect the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He mentioned here hadith. One hadith in this chapter. Abu Shuraih radiyallahu ta'ala an, Abu Shuraih radiyallahu ta'ala narrated, my nickname was Abu al-Hakam. Okay. What is the nickname here? It means kunya. What is the meaning of the kunya? For example, my name is Ahmed. People call me Abu Abdurrahman, the father of Abdurrahman. So my name is Ahmed and my kunya Abu Abdurrahman. What is your name? Maybe your name is Aisha. And what people call you? People call you Anas. So your nickname or your kunya, Anas. So in Arabic, we call this kunya. Also, it can be Ibn. Okay, like Ibn Umar. What's his name? His name, Abdullah ibn Umar. What is his nickname? Ibn Umar. And sometimes it is the kunya, it is the name. Yani you'll find some people and the companions or the scholars. What is his name? His name is Abu Bakr, for example. When you check what is his name, it is his name, Abu Bakr. He doesn't have a son called Bakr. He is Abu Bakr, for example, I'm saying. So the nickname, when you put Ab or or Ibn or Ibn, okay, Abu Huraira, Abu Abdullah, Abu Abdurrahman, or Ibn Umar, Ibn Am, Ibn, like this. So this is kunya. So he said, my kunya was Abu al-Hakam. My kunya was Abu al-Hakam. My nickname was Abu al-Hakam. Hakam means the judge. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to me, Allah is al-Hakam. Allah is the judge. And to Him judgment belongs. I said, so Abu Shuraih explained why people, why his nickname Abu al-Hakam. He said, radiyallahu ta'ala an, when my people disagree about a matter, they come to me and I arbitrate between them and both parties accept my decision. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, how good this is. Do you have any children? I replied, I have Shuraih, Muslim, and Abdullah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, who is the eldest of them? I replied, Shuraih. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, then you are Abu Shuraih, related by Abu Dawood and others. And this is one of the things that we like the Muslims to use this way. I mean the kunya. The kunya. Yani many times when the brothers coming to the halqa, but today no one comes. Okay. I'm doing the class here in the masjid, and anyone is welcome to come in the masjid. We are in Kuwait. Hayakum Allah, you are welcome if you like to attend. You attend online or offline, you are welcome. So what is your name? Sabil. What is your name? Muhammad. What is your name? Sa'ad. What is your name? Akbar. What is your name? Ali. Okay. It is not common, I notice among the brothers, to use the kunya. Okay. We should train ourselves to use the kunya, also among the sisters. Okay, you know, some of them don't like that. No, my name is nice. My name is Zainab. My name is Aliya. My name is Rabi'a. Okay, I like people to call me like these names. Okay, of course, no problem if you like that. But also, we should not forget this is the way. Even for those who don't have children. Okay, yani, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam called one of the companions, he was very young, maybe he was 5 years old or 6 years old, he was calling him with a nickname, Abu Umayr. Another female companion, she was maybe 1 or 2 years old or something like this, he was calling her Khalid. She's not married, she doesn't have children, she's very young, Khalid. Okay, so this is a kind of respect. We should train ourselves to use this way. Abu Abdullah, Abu Muhammad, Khalid, Ali. This is very important. Okay, this is, yani, I'm not saying this is wajib. Okay, but very nice. And this is common in the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So please, sister, from today, okay, you try to, I'm not saying this is compulsory, but train yourself. Don't think that you will forget your name. You'll not forget your name. People will not forget your name. Yes, sometimes, you know, maybe one of the brothers here, what is the name we call him, for example, Abu Abdullah. So he's with us maybe 10 years. If you ask me, what is his name? I don't know, he's Abu Abdullah. Also, this is wrong, you don't know the name of the person. Okay, because you are using the nickname, use the nickname and you should know the name. Again, I will not say this is wajib compulsory that you should do that, but we need to practice that this way. Okay, back to the hadith. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to this companion, Inna Allah huwa al-hakam. Inna Allah huwa al-hakam. Allah is the judge. The companion, Abu Sharih, explained why people calling me Abu al-Hakam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised him. Yes, this is nice. When you try to reconcile among people, this is nice. This is good. This is one of the great deeds. لا خير في كثير من نجواب إلا من أمر بصدقة أو معروف أو إصلاح بين الناس. As we mentioned today in the tafsir class in the morning before 9 hours. The class was before 9 hours. Before 11 hours. Every Saturday I have the tafsir class and alhamdulillah we finish Surah Al-Fatiha, Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Ali Imran, and now almost yani, we finish more than half of Surah Al-Nisa. And also yani, there is inshallah this is glad tidings that alhamdulillah there is a project of tafsir al-Quran, the full Quran. Okay, you'll find this in the YouTube channel of Green Lane Masjid by Dr. Ahsan Hanif, mashallah. Very nice tafsir, simple. Okay, I not summarize, nice. Every lesson, maybe 25 minutes, something like this. And inshallah, I think every day or every 2 days, they will upload a video. The project will be, I don't know, maybe 300 lectures or something like this. 300, 600 lectures. I'm not sure. طيب. So it is nice that every day you listen to a lecture. طيب. So here, very nice. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the tafsir by Ahsan Hib, Green Lane Masjid, Green Lane Masjid channel. And my tafsir is on my Instagram. Also, you can find this in my channel, YouTube channel, Ahmed Al-Ruhi. So, إن الله هو الحكم. So, Allah is the judge. Allah is the judge. So, don't use this name. Why? Because this is one of the names of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the attributes of Allah. Why? He said, وَإِلَيْهِ الْحُكُمْ. Here, Allah is al-hakam. And to him, judgment belongs. So it is not only a name, also an attribute. طيب. Here, if you check the explanation of Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, he said, using the name Al-Hakam, is it haram or not haram? He said, it depends. The meaning of the fatwa of Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen, it depends. If you are using the name Al-Hakam, because of the meaning, like this hadith, then it is not allowed. Okay, why you are al-hakam, you are called al-hakam, or what? Why you are called Abu al-hakam? Wallahi, because of the judgment. If you gave the same answer like Abu Shireh, then it is haram. But if there is a brother, what is his name? His name is al-hakam, or Abu al-hakam. We ask him, what is the meaning of your name? He said, well, I don't know. He doesn't know. He did not think about the meaning of his name. Then is it allowed? Yes, it is allowed. Why? They say, because when you check in the hadith, you will find that some companions, their name Al-Hakam or Hakim, like Hakim ibn Hizam. So that's why they say it is allowed. Or sorry, yani, that's why they said it depends. Why you have the name Al-Hakam, the judge? Is it because of the meaning? Okay, we call you Al-Hakam because the meaning you are doing the judgment, or it is just a name? It is just the name. You are nothing about the meaning. You don't know the meaning. So if you are using this name because you know the meaning and the attribute, then we tell you, no, please, you should avoid that and change your name. Because Allah is al-hakam. But if, wallahi, you said, wallahi, my father gave me this name. Why? We don't know. Or because one of the companions, his name al-hakam. What's his name al-hakam? Or maybe we know, but we are not thinking about the meaning at all. Then it is allowed. Then it is allowed. So here, what do you notice? Sheikh Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah, he did not say haram or halal. He said it depends. Why you are using this name? If you are using this name because of the meaning, you should avoid. If you are using this name, just wallahi, you like the sound, al-hakam. Okay, because wallahi, all of your children, their name starts with the letter ha. Hamid, Hawra, Hayyan. Okay, so you like Ha. So you gave the name Al-Hakam. You went and you checked the dictionary, okay, or a book of names. Ha, Al-Hakam, yeah. What does it mean? I don't know, I don't care. And this is allowed. Then this is allowed. So this is, subhanAllah, the importance, brothers and sisters, to read what the scholars say about the hadith. We need the scholars. We need the scholars. So I'll stop here. And shall I will give today more time, because I think last week we did not give any time for the questions. Today is 21st October. We take some time for the questions.
أضيع. Sorry, let me change the position, then I can read the question. Okay.
Yeah, question. My husband's name is Zahir. He did not use that. Everyone are calling him Shahid. My wedding day on registration, he gave Shahid. Will it okay in Islam? Still, he did not change it. Is it possible? Second, when, what is the meaning of Farzana? My husband's name is Zahir. He did not use that. Okay, why he's not using Zahir? Zahir, exactly. Well, I don't know the meaning of Zahir. But Shahid. Okay, also, what is the problem with Shahid? Okay, I don't know what is the problem with Shahid. Farzan, wallahi, I don't know. I don't know. Maybe if I check, you can send me a question. Inshallah, I try to find the meaning for you, inshallah. There are two YouTube channels with your name. I'm unsure. It is Ahmed Rahman channel, Ahmed Rahman. The one who has the last lecture was Tafsir, Surah Nisa today. Maybe, maybe some people, they post my lectures and they put my name. Okay. The one which I have the access, I have the password. It is called Ahmed Rum, AhmadAlromh. Okay. And you will find the last class, Tafsir, Surah Nisa. And also you find the Jum'ah khutbah about the dua yesterday. Is it not important to know the meaning of a name before naming your child? Yes, it is important because, sometimes you choose a name and it sounds nice. But after maybe 1 year or after 1 month or after years, you realize this is wrong meaning or it is haram name. So you should know. You should know from the beginning. Okay, chuf. Look, there are names. I don't know, yeah, and maybe I can say it is not important to know the name, the meaning. Why? Because it is a very common, no doubt it is allowed. For example, I should not check what is the meaning of, if I give the name to my son Muhammad, Uthman, Anas, Abdurrahman, Umar, Aisha, Fatima, for sure allowed names, okay? And I'm sure that many Muslims don't know the meaning of this name. Fatima, Khadija, okay? But no doubt this is allowed. Can a female be called Rahma? Inshallah, this is allowed, the name Rahma. Inshallah, this is allowed, the name Rahma, as I remember the fatwa from the scholars. Sheikh, can the name Rahman be used in the same sense and principle as Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen? No, Rahman, no. Rahman, no. Okay, there are names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cannot be used for people, whatever the intention. Allah, Rahman, Jabbar, okay, Khalla. You should not use these names. With Al, without Al, you should not use these names for people. Okay, how we know that? You'll find the scholars talk about these names. Okay, you'll find the scholars talk about these names. Deciding this is allowed or not allowed. And also, how to use the interpretation of Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen. Because, Rahman, it is only Allah Rahman, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? This is only Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rahman. Rahim, yes, this is okay, Rahim. There's many requests to read Surah Yasin and Tasbih for the people of Palestine. Example, 1 million Yasin and Ayat. Is this in accordance with? No. Nothing in the Sunnah, as I know, Allahu A'lam. Nothing in the Sunnah like that. You recite Surah Yasin 100 times, 1 million times. Let's read, let's fast this day. These brothers, when people follow this bid'ah or not Sunnah things, people will miss the Sunnah. What is in the Sunnah, sisters? If we want the victory, the Prophet ﷺ told us the solution. The solution is not to protest. The solution is not to shout, okay, and to accuse others and to blame the rulers. The Sunnah is حَتَّى تَرْجِعُوا إِلَى دِينُكُمْ, until you come back to your religion. Come back to the Quran. Quran and Sunnah. By Allah, wallahi, we will defeat the, not only the Jews, all the enemies. If we, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Yahya, Ya Yahya, خُذِ الْكِتَابَ بِقُوَّةِ. Oh Yahya, hold the book in a strong way, which means follow the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Take it seriously. Nowadays, you can notice the Muslims, not, wallahi, yesterday, after Jum'ah khutbah, one of the brothers, yani he's attending Jum'ah khutbah, attending one of the lectures. Do you know what kind of discussion we had? We were trying to convince him, don't use the riba bank. He has account in a riba bank. Alhamdulillah, in Kuwait, we have five Islamic banks, alhamdulillah. What do you mean by Islamic banks? In every bank, there is a Sharia committee. Anything happens in the bank, it should be through the Sharia committee. If they approve, they do it. If they don't approve, they will not do it. I mean, this is the rule. And we have, unfortunately, we have riba banks. So this brother, mashallah, he is coming. Okay. What's the problem? Because, you know, they have facilities more than the Islamic. Astaghfirullah, Habibi, you are fighting the riba. We should fight the riba. We should fight the riba banks. And you are supporting them? No, I'm not taking the interest from them. Habibi, we are in a Muslim country and we have Islamic banks. So this is very important. This is very important. So back to the point. If you want to support the Palestinian, if you want to support Muslims everywhere, in your country, other countries, come back to the religion of Allah. Learn the religion of Allah and apply it. This is very important. حَتَّى تَرْجِعُوا إِلَى دِينِكُمْ. What is the solution? We should come back to the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Sheikh, please suggest me girl baby name today morning. She born for sister-in-law. MashaAllah. May Allah bless her. Okay, yani when I tell brothers or sisters, yani for sure, when you tell me, I will suggest a name like Hafsa, Aisha, Fatima, Khadija, Maryam, these names. Asya, I know many people, they like something new. Okay, yani my mentality, use these names. Or if your mother, if your grandmother, their name is okay, nice, use this. Make your mother happy like that, yani. But even if the meaning is okay. Can I use my husband's surname as Al-Banna after my name instead of my father's name? No. If I'm asking you, what is your name? Okay, your name, for example, Fatma Khalid. Halas, you are Fatma Khalid. Okay, but you say, if I am Fatma Khalid Al-Banna, you add al-banna because this is your husband's family name. No, this is not the Muslim way. This is not the Muslim way. What I know, this is the non-Muslim way. My brother's name is Abdul Aziz, but everyone called him Aziz. Is that haram to call him? No, it is not haram. It's okay to call him Aziz because as we mentioned, Aziz, Rahim, Ra'uf, this is okay. Advise me, my first son name is Muhammad Hamid, but later I learn I should have named him Abdul Hamid. So do I have to apply to change him? Okay, first thing, no need to keep the combined name. I notice in some places, most of them, okay, or many of them, combined name. Muhammad Shafiq, Muhammad Abul Kalam, Muhammad, they like to put Muhammad. Okay, use one name. When you check the names of the companions, radiallahu ta'ala, the names of the prophets, alayhi salatu wasalam, single. Hud, Saleh, Adam, Yusuf, Yaqub, Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Isa, عليه الصلاة والسلام one name. So no need for two names. The other one, Muhammad Hamid. Okay, I'm not sure wallahi about using Hamid for the person. I need to check that. So, or maybe you can check. Can we call an author name like Moon? His name is Mohsen. Can we call an author name? I don't know. Is Farsi name Farzana? Is it clever? I don't know. As I mentioned, yeah, I need to avoid the combined names. Okay. But is it haram? No, I cannot say. Well, my sister's child is not being named, even though he is 7 months old. As sister and her husband are not agreeing. Every time they come to one name, the elders change mind of one of them and ends in a fight. And they are still not making birth certificate. 7 months. I think you are telling me 7 days. 7 months. Allahu musta'an. What can I advise them? I still heard. Alaykum salam. I told her to have sabr and leave it to him. But even then, some other problems arise. As we are expats and child has no visa yet, I am very worried. Of course, we should not be like that. No, we should not be like that. Okay. Basically, the right of giving the name is for the father, not the mother. Okay, I know some people say, but I was pregnant 9 months and I went through many troubles. At the end, he's choosing the name. Jazakallah khairan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not forget your tiredness, and Allah will not subhanahu wa ta'ala leave you like that. Allah will reward you, inshallah. Okay, but if there is fight, if there is something, okay, the father, it is the right of the father. Tayyib, and you know, now the problem, he doesn't have visa. It is 7 months. What you are calling this boy? The boy, or the boy, the son of so and so. We should not fight like that. Wallahi, yani, sometimes when you come to know about these problems, look our brothers and sisters in Gaza. They are being killed day and night. Now I think more than 3,000 or more than 4,000. This is the registered number. Allahu alam about the fact, maybe more. Okay? And we are fighting because of a name. This is the Muslim Ummah. Subhanallah. People doing riba, zina, many troubles, and we are fighting about names. Allahu musta'an. Assalamu alaikum, Sheikh. Is it necessary to keep the name along with Muhammad? No need. Okay. If you like the name Muhammad, khalas, you name your son Muhammad. Full stop. Okay, but you call him. Because what I notice, as I said, Muhammad Shafiq, Muhammad Abu al-Kalam, Muhammad Abdul Rahman, Muhammad Muhammad Umar. So what people practice, okay, it is written. His name combined, Muhammad, another one. Then they ignore the name Muhammad. When his name is Muhammad Shafiq, what we call him? We call him Shafiq. And we ignore Muhammad. So what is the point to put Muhammad? Either you name him Muhammad or Shafiq, for example. But I call him Muhammad Shafiq or Muhammad Abu al-Kalam or Muhammad Abdullah. And I call Abdullah, ignoring Muhammad, not nice. It's not correct. Allah is Mary full Quran? Tahfim, I don't know. When we do the recitation, we learn it with Ada. How this is different from Ada, you said. Does it have the same root letter? Sheikh, when we do the recitation, we learn it with Ada. Maybe I'm not sure. Maybe you mean Sister Asma, Rasha. Ada. Maybe you mean Ada. How to recite the Quran. Ada. But I'm talking about Ada. 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 Dal, not Dal. sister's story, time finish. Please, if I not answer your question, you can send my your question. I'm available WhatsApp, Telegram, Instagram, YouTube. طيب, if you like, you can send your question, and inshallah, if I know the answer, I will answer. I will send the answer. جزاكم الله خيرا. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.